With electric vehicles becoming more and more commonplace on both our roads and our job sites, more electronic components than ever are being integrated into new vehicle designs. With these high-power electronic components being integrated into such small spaces, EMI becomes more of a concern than ever. The KEB T6 Auxiliary Inverter takes into account these concerns by addressing EMI through various EMC strategies. EMI stands for Electromagnetic Interference. This is the noise that shows up on electromagnetic signals. It can cause problems in the intended operation of electronic components. There's different types of interference. You can see different types on this graphic here, but the types we'll be talking about are radiative and conductive emissions. Radiative emissions are the kind of emissions that take place when current flows through a conductor like this. Current flowing through generates a magnetic field, and this magnetic field can jump between conductors. An example of this would be a high voltage DC conductor causing interference with a low voltage communication cable. Conductive emissions are the kind of interference that's transmitted through a conductor. With this cable here, you could have the example of an inverter with a high switching frequency, transmitting that interference through the conductor to another component. EMC stands for electromagnetic compatibility. EMC is the ability of an electronic device to ensure that no interference is being transmitted either from the device to other devices or other devices to our device. It's important to make sure that your electronic device meets the standards for your application. For electric vehicle applications, some of the important standards are ECE R10 and CISPR 25. When implementing EMC, it's important to address the situation with design as opposed to patchwork solutions down the road. When implementing patchwork solutions, it's difficult to troubleshoot EMC because EMI is an unseen force and it's hard to measure. The T6 addresses EMC with various strategies. The first of these is integrated DC EMC filters. These filters are designed to mitigate conductive emissions. It does this by protecting external devices from the high switching frequencies within the inverter, making sure those aren't conducted out. And also the T6 uses those filters to prevent external noise from coming into the inverter. The T6 also features shielded cables and connectors. These connectors prevent radiative emissions from being transmitted from the inverter to other devices, as well as preventing other devices from causing adverse effects to the inverter. Importantly, the T6's shielded connectors ensure that the entire system is shielded. Without these connectors, the shielding would only be as strong as the weakest link. Additionally, KEB performs rigorous testing to make sure that the T6 meets all EMC requirements. Being a company that makes filters, we have our own EMC test bench where we can perform all the testing we need to on the inverter. KEB can test to ECE R10 and CISPR 25, as well as testing to more stringent OEM standards in-house. Because of all these factors, the T6 is able to protect itself from external interference, as well as preventing interference from going out to other electronic devices. To demonstrate this, the T6 supports up to 30 meters of cable length per inverter output. Just to demonstrate, let's go see how long 30 meters really is. That is 30 meters. That's almost the length of 3 whole school buses. That is a lot of cable. These are just some of the ways that the T6 protects against EMI. In this way, the T6 can be mounted in a central location, so it doesn't have to be mounted right next to the motors. Please contact a KEB Applications Engineer to learn more.